The T-14 Armata main battle tank is one of Russia's most ambitious and highly anticipated military projects in recent years. It is considered a significant breakthrough in tank design, incorporating advanced technologies such as an unmanned turret, an active protection system, and a powerful 125mm Smoothbore gun. The Armata's frontal base armor reportedly surpasses all existing tanks in the world, making it highly resistant to modern anti-tank missiles and other threats. It also features a state-of-the-art fire control system, advanced sensors, and a modular design that allows for easy customization. The T-14 Armata is a symbol of Russia's technological prowess and military might, and its deployment represents a significant advancement in the country's defense capabilities. However, the T-14 Armata has faced some setbacks, including technical issues and production delays, which have slowed its introduction into the Russian military. Additionally, its high cost has limited the number of units that can be produced, and questions have been raised about the tank's effectiveness due to a lack of actual experience. Despite these challenges, the Russian government remains committed to the program, citing the T-14 Armata's advanced capabilities and potential for further development as reasons to maintain its production. So, let's take a closer look at the T-14 Armata. Its novel design, armament, as well as protection and mobility capabilities. The T-14 Armata is a next-generation main battle tank produced by the Russian Ural Design Bureau of Transport Machine Building, which has a long history of producing tanks for the Russian military. The T-14 Armata was first publicly revealed at the Moscow Victory Day Parade in May 2015 and represents a total break from Soviet-era designs. The tank boasts digitalized equipment, an unmanned turret, and an armored crew capsule. Originally, the Russian armed forces planned to introduce 2,300 Armata tanks between 2015 and 2020, but mass production was delayed due to the high cost, sanctions, and changes in the political climate. The tanks were field tested in Syria as part of their development and evaluation process. In December 2021, the Russian state conglomerate Rostec announced that the mass production of the Armata tank had begun, with plans to deliver more than 40 units to the Russian military after 2023. However, only 8 tanks have been confirmed through sightings in the annual Victory Day parade in Moscow so far. Regardless, it is still important to examine some of the key specifications of the T-14 Armata main battle tank. The Armata Universal Combat Platform is a modular platform designed to be the basis for a variety of armored vehicles, including infantry fighting vehicles, armored personnel carriers, and main battle tanks, including the T-14. The T-14 Armata hull is divided into 3 compartments, with the crew cab located at the front, an unmanned remote-controlled turret in the center, and the power pack at the rear. The driver, gunner, and commander sit inside a special armored capsule, with entry and exit provided through 3 hatches located in front of the hull. The roof of the turret houses various communication antennas, including a meteorological mast, satellite communications, global navigation satellite system, data link, and radio communications. The T-14 Armata measures 10.8 meters in length, 4 meters in width, 3.3 meters in height, and has a combat weight of 49 tons. The T-14 Armata is equipped with a 125mm Smoothbore cannon, capable of firing a range of ammunition types, including armor-piercing fin-stabilized discarding sabot rounds, high-explosive anti-tank rounds, and guided missiles, with a range of 5,000 meters. The tank's automatic loader system allows for a high rate of fire, with a reported maximum rate of 12 rounds per minute. The cannon is designed to be easily interchangeable with a larger caliber weapon, such as the developmental 152mm gun. In addition to the main cannon, the T-14 Armata is also equipped with a 7.62mm coaxial machine gun and a 12.7mm machine gun mounted on the commander's turret for anti-aircraft defense. The tank also features an advanced fire control system and digital battlefield management system, providing enhanced situational awareness and targeting capabilities. The T-14 Armata is designed with advanced composite armor and features an active protection system, making it one of the most heavily protected main battle tanks in the world. The APS, known as the Afghanet, is capable of intercepting incoming anti-tank missiles and rockets, providing additional protection to the tank and its crew. The tank's hull and turret are also designed to have a low radar signature, reducing the likelihood of detection by enemy sensors. The T-14 Armata features a nuclear, biological, and chemical protection system, ensuring that the crew can operate safely in a variety of environments. Russia has a long history of developing tank engines, with many of their designs being renowned for their power and reliability. However, the development of new engines has been a challenge for the Russian tank industry in recent years. The T-14 Armata is powered by the A85-3A turbocharged diesel engine, which generates a power output of 1,200 horsepower. The tank can reportedly reach speeds of up to 90 km per hour on road and 70 km per hour off-road, making it one of the fastest tanks in the world. The Armata also has an impressive range, with a maximum cruising range of 500 km on a single tank of fuel. The tank's suspension system is designed to provide superior cross-country performance, with adjustable hydraulic dampers and torsion bars that allow for smooth movement over rough terrain. Additionally, the T-14 Armata features an active suspension system that adjusts to the terrain in real time, providing enhanced stability and maneuverability in all conditions. In early 2023, the UK Defence Ministry released an intelligence report stating that Russia may deploy the T-14 Armata main battle tank in Ukraine for propaganda purposes rather than a military advantage due to the development issues we've mentioned. As of April 2023, there are no official reports of the deployment of T-14 Armata in Ukraine. So, what do you think? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more content.